So hello, welcome to the Security Dev Room again. We are here to hear about footprinting. Please welcome Jose. Yeah.
Good morning.
Good morning, and thank you for coming. And well, my name is Jose Manuel Ortega, and I'm from Spain. And this talk is oriented to mainly security auditors, pen testers in general, interested in footprinting tools and other tools for obtaining information from servers and domains and so on. These are the main points I will talk. I will make an introduction to information gathering. What is information gathering and the footprinting tools that we have for testing, for obtaining this information from servers. Later we comment other tools like Nmap and Nmap scripts for obtaining information in a more active way from the servers. Well, where we are auditing a server, a domain, a site, these are the main phases that we have for obtaining the information or testing a server. We have the first analysis phase. In this phase, the target is analyze all public information that is available in internet in general and the information that server returns. In this phase, we can use tools like quiz, densu lookup, sharing engines in general, enumeration tools, and so on. The second phase is the scanning. In this phase, we can check vulnerabilities for specific targets. The idea is, in this phase is analyze the ports that are open in a specific server, domain, or site. And the last phase, when we have all information, the last phase is try to exploit the vulnerabilities that we have found. And in this phase, we can use tools like buffer overflows, techniques like buffer overflows, spoofing, password rootkits, and so on. In this talk, I will center in the fifth phase, in the analysis phase, where when the target is obtain all the information about our target. What is information gathering? Information gathering basically is a process where we can extract all information about
again.
Yeah?
Do you have a pacemaker or something?
Okay. Well, in this phase, the objective of this phase is gather all information, name, addresses, system types, operating system, and so on. Okay. In this phase, all information, the objective of this information is obtain this information in a passive way, that's in a non-intrusive mode. There are other phases similar to footprinting, like fingerprinting. Fingerprinting is like footprinting, but oriented to obtain, for example, the topology of a network, operating system, service that run in a specific server or system. The sniffing, classical sniffing for recollect network traffic, and other and scanning. I will center later in this phase. We commenting the map tool. Well, the main tools that I will comment are available in Kali Linux. Kali Linux is a distribution oriented to pen testing. In this tool, in this distribution, we can find Maltego in map, Recon.ing, Sparta for scanning ports, ZenMap is a graphical version of Nmap. Well, I comment now these tools. Well, the first thing that we can do for testing, for obtaining information, is use classical WHIS online tools. The WHIS command, basically what this does is provides more information about the specific domain. It returns IP address, DNS servers, and basically with these tools, with online, for example, with Netcraft, we can obtain all information related with servers, domain servers, or for a specific domain. There are other tools, online tools, like WHIS, and the WHIS command that is available in all operating systems. In this case, we are obtaining information about the register and name of the domain, and more information about the domain. Also, we have the host command. The host command provides, for example, information about the IP address in versions 4 and 6, and provides also the mail server of the domain. There are more tools, online tools that we can use in free way. Network tools, we can execute commands over a specific target or domain. We can execute ping, trusted root, and so on. There are more tools like Tollbooks, and for example, these tools called Robtex is similar to the others, but the difference is that provides information in a graphical way. It provides the same information, but we can see the relations between the domains and who is server information. Another of the commands that we can use, is lookup. This command provides information about the host machine, basically. And with the D parameter, we can list all associated records for a specific domain. Basically, with NSC lookup, we can search by IP address or domain, depending what we need. It resolves the reverse lookup. Other tools that we have in Unix systems and in some Linux distributions are DIG and DNS resolver. DNS resolver is a graphical application that returns the DNS servers for a specific domain. We can see that it returns, for example, the authorities servers. The authorities servers are the servers that holds the information about the DNS servers and resolves all the DNS requests. We have more tools like DNS map that returns more information about the specific domain, and DNS enum also it provides more information for this topic. And DNS recon, for example, it provides information related, for example, if the server is using DNSSEC securing the DNS server. It returns Information about the keys of the DNS server. The functionality provides what is called a SOA transfer. And the question at this point is, what does one provide security against DNS interrogation? The idea is restrict the zone transfers only to authorized servers. For example, if we the best practice at this point is restrict the zone transfer only to IP addresses that we can control in our network, for example. And the idea is review the file configuration that is in the path /bin/name.com.local. In this file, we can configure the IP address for allowing the DNS transfers, zone transfers in our server. Well, another tool. Well, until now, I recommend other tools. For example, the Harvester. The Harvester allows recover information about the specific domain. We can recover information about the emails, subdomains. This is a tool developed in Python, and in an easy way, we can extract information about domain, email address. Searching in the main search engines like Google, Bing, Twitter, LinkedIn, Yahoo, and so on. If we want to recover subdomains in a more easy way, we have, for example, the api.hackertarget.com. We can pass as parameter the domain we want to extract subdomains, and in a easy way we can get this information without register, without no more than doing this request. Another interesting tools that I'm commenting now is Maltego. Maltego is oriented also for printing tasks. Maltego has basically four level. Of four levels for obtaining this information. For example, if we want to obtain basic information gathering, we have level one. If we want to moderate amount of information gathering, we have level two. And we have more. We want to more intensive and most complete information gathering, we have level three. For example, in this screen capture, we can see that with Maltego, in a graphical way, we can extract email addresses, subdomains, files and documents for a specific domain. All this information is recovered with what is called transforms. Transform, Maltego transforms are all the way for obtaining this information. And also we have Shodan. Shodan is a very useful tool for obtaining a view, a first view of what the server has, the port service that are open, and so on. Also we have other tools like Thensys. Thensys is like Shodan, provides more information about the specific server, is returns. You can see the certificates of the server, the location of the server, and so on. And another tool oriented to these tags is Mr. Locker. Mr. Locker has the particularity that you can search in the IP. In the IP version 6 space, and you can get information from version 6 addresses.
Well, for getting more information from servers, for example, WebArchive, it provides from 1996 all sites the historical or information of a specific site. In this screen capture, we can see that we can see the first Fosden site in 2001. There are other tools, interesting tools for footprinting, like Spanish food. We can with the Spanish food is we can obtain more information about the specific domain. And finally, commenting. Until now, I comment the tools that we don't need to. We analyze our target in a passive way, and now I'm commenting tools for active footprinting. That is analyze the pods that are open, service that are running the servers, vulnerabilities, and so on. The classical tool for this task is NMAP. NMAP basically is a port scanner that supports different scanning techniques. It has the capacity for detecting operating systems on remote hosts, and it has another interesting features like NMAP script engine for detecting vulnerabilities in specific port, for example. Later we will see an example. The graphical version of NMAP is called ZenMap for scanner, and we can use this tool without learning any command from NMAP. Also, we can obtain, for example, the topology of a network. For example, if we execute the traced route with NMAP, we can obtain the topology, what are the hosts that that we are passing for the packets and so on. Emma provides an interesting parameters for obtaining specific information. For example, we can execute the whois command with NMAP for obtain the same information that we have with the classical whois command. Also, we can, for example, detecting the operating system with the specific parameter. We can force to NMAP to discover the operating system. In this screen capture, we can see that it not returns only one operating system. What it does is is guessing a operating system with a percentage. And it returns all operating system that can be possible in this machine. Also provides other techniques, for example, obtain the banner grabbing. The banner grabbing, basically, we can obtain the information about servers, the version of the server, the operating system, and the application that are running in the machine. And finally, the last tool I will comment is NMAP script engine. Basically, NMAP script engine are simple scripts to automate the classical network stacks. For example, if we want to detect vulnerabilities in a specific port, if we want to make a specific task for network discovery or backdoor detection or vulnerability exploitation, we can use this script for these tasks. These scripts are written in Lua programming language, and where these scripts, we can find the scripts in the root share SLAD and map scripts. There are a lot of scripts. In this screen capture, we can see that, for example, we can obtain the service. 1 minute. We can obtain information, more information about a specific service in the HTTP with the HTTP enum, for example. We can obtain other services that are available in this, that are listening in a specific port. And another task basically are, for example, for detecting obtaining data that tables from databases. And finally, for example, we can find vulnerabilities with NetMap with specific scripts that are available in the NetMap script engine. And the last point where we are analyze all information, the next step is introducing the vulnerability scanner. We can use, for example, OpenBAS, that is open source, or Arachne vulnerability scanner, that are also open source. These are tools for the next step, where we have all information about our target, and it detect vulnerabilities, for example. The next step is using this tool. And finally, like links and reference, and books related with this topic. Thank you.
Thank you, Jose. We have some help with the mic here, but we'll have 2 minutes for questions. Anyone raise your hand?